Keratoconus is a relatively common disorder of the cornea of the eye. It results in blurred vision that's difficult to correct and often requires specialty lenses called sclerals in order to best correct patients' vision. But what causes it? In today's video, I'll explain the most common causes of keratoconus. This is iSchool with me, Dr. D, where I teach you about products and treatments related to dry eye syndrome and eye beauty. I'm an eye doctor that treats patients with dry eye, and I pay special attention to makeup and skincare. I even have an esthetician that I work closely with in my practice. I am obsessed with helping you achieve beautiful, comfortable, and healthy eyes. Make sure to hit the subscribe button if you enjoy my videos, as I do publish weekly. Your cornea is the clear, dome-shaped window at the front of your eye. It focuses light into your eye and allows you to see. So keratoconus occurs when the cornea thins out and bulges much like a cone. Changing the shape of the cornea brings light rays out of focus, and as a result, your vision is blurry and distorted, making daily tasks like reading or driving difficult. In addition, the visual difficulty from keratoconus is not easily corrected as in other refractive errors. We don't know for sure why people develop keratoconus. However, there are several causes that play a role. So first we have genetics, which are the cause in about 10% of cases. It is possible to have a parent or a sibling who might have keratoconus as well. The second cause, and this is a really, really big one, is eye rubbing. So we know that eye rubbing plays a significant role in the pathogenesis of the disease. And interestingly, patients who develop keratoconus tend to rub their eyes differently than other patients. So this is something I've noticed in my clinic and just talking to my patients with keratoconus, is that I'm going to demonstrate for you how people rub their eyes. So if you have allergies, seasonal allergies, typically you're going to do like this along the lid margin, sort of delicately. You might get here in the corners of your eyes in the inner canthus, but typically you're not getting in deep. And if you ask patients with keratoconus how they rub their eyes, almost always they get a knuckle out just like this and they go in round circles on their eyes, very, very deep, and really get in there. And I just have always found that very interesting. I've also noticed that patients will often sleep on the side where their keratoconus is worse. So if you ask a keratoconus patient how they sleep, a lot of times they'll sleep on their belly with their face down in the pillow with a hand kind of up under the pillow, almost like always putting pressure on their eyes. So that could potentially cause pressure on the eye all night long. So why does eye rubbing cause keratoconus? It's been hypothesized that the pressure exerted on the cornea breaks down the collagen bonds of the cornea, resulting in that thinning over time. When the cornea thins, you get that cone-like effect or that bulging effect, which changes the whole topography of the cornea, the whole curvature of the cornea. So next we have eye allergies as a cause, although it seems like that might be related to the eye rubbing that I just talked about, because if you have that stimulus, that itchiness that makes you want to rub, you know, that's what's going to kind of trigger patients to rub their eye and rub it hard. And I do put my patients with keratoconus on a prophylactic allergy drop to reduce the stimulus to rub or itch their eyes. Another absolute cause of keratoconus are systemic connective tissue diseases. So I don't mean absolute, meaning it's in every patient with these diseases, but it's definitely associated with connective tissue disorders. The first of which is Marfan syndrome, and then secondly, we have Ehlers-Danlos. Those are two connective tissue disorders that result in a larger proportion of patients with the disease having keratoconus. So keratoconus often starts when people are in their late teens to early 20s, and the vision symptoms slowly get worse over a period of about 10 to 20 years. Keratoconus often affects both eyes and can lead to very different vision between the two eyes. The symptoms can differ in each eye, and they can change over time. In the early stage, keratoconus symptoms can include mild blurring of vision, slightly distorted vision, where straight lines might look bent or wavy. You could have double or triple or even more images to your vision, than that. And you can even have light and glare, redness, or swelling of the eyes. Even in the early stage, these changes in the vision can cause depth perception issues. In later stages, keratoconus symptoms often include more blur, distorted vision, increased nearsightedness or astigmatism when your eye can't focus as well as it should. And as a result, you might need new eyeglass prescriptions often, or not be able to wear soft contact lenses. They may no longer fit you properly and might be uncomfortable. At that point, you might need hard lenses, RGPs, mini sclerals, or even scleral designs, because those vulture cornea, trapping tears and giving you a more normal refractive surface, eliminating all that extra glare and visual difficulty. Keratoconus usually takes years to go from early to late stage. For some people, though, it can get worse very quickly. The cornea can swell suddenly and start to scar. When the cornea has scar tissue, it loses its smoothness and becomes less clear. And as a result, the vision grows even more distorted and blurry. And that process of it getting much worse very quickly is called corneal high drops, which can occur. So these later stages of keratoconus are considered advanced. So in the future, I will be talking about keratoconus and the latest treatments in a dedicated video to treatments that will be coming out in the next couple months. So make sure to stay tuned for that if you're interested in knowing the latest in keratoconus treatments. That is going to be it for today's iSchool lesson about keratoconus causes. Class is dismissed, and I will see you next time.